Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Cliven Bundy's going to be joining us coming up in the next segment with updates on what could be the start of the new brushfire rebellions. This time will 1776 start out in the Nevada desert. I hope it's a cultural revolution against their cultural revolution. I hope we can win the hearts and minds of the enforcers, which I know we are. I'm not enemies of the BLM. But seeing them taser people and attack women from behind, I mean, I'm just glad I'm not dishonorable like that. The system wants an imperious attitude against the public so that we'll shut up and let them do whatever they want. Joe Scarborough has come out and said the Bundys should just obey the law. And that's the George Soros line. That's the Media Matters line. That's the other big radio conservative talk show host line. You see, it's their job as Republican hacks to keep everybody on the plantation, to act like they're for property rights, to act like they're for freedom, to act like they're revolutionaries for liberty. But in truth, ladies and gentlemen, they're just there playing the part of the opposition. And as soon as Republicans get back in office, they have every intention, you can bet your bottom dollar, of accelerating the police state takeover. And then the Democrats will suddenly start criticizing the NSA and torture and secret arrest. It's a joke. We need to take over the Republican Party with real libertarians. That's what the whole power structure is scared of, because they've identified an avenue that's our best shot of taking the country back. The Republican platform at the state level in places like Texas is very good. The problem is the Republican Party of Texas is run by people like David Dewhurst and Rick Perry that talk the talk big time, but don't walk the walk. And it's disgusting. Now, I have a lot of different clips. We've got the Bundys coming up. Do we happen to have Scarborough where he says abide by the law? I know Kurt Nemo wrote an article up at Infowars.com. That wasn't affirmative. We have that? Okay, great. Thank you. But here's another headline up on Infowars.com. Feds desperate to hide Harry Reid link to Bundy land grab. That's a big deal. And Paul Watson has done a special video report on that. But also, he's going to be writing an article in and around it. The feds are so desperate to hide Harry Reid's connection to the communist Chinese energy company linked to the Cliven Bundy land grab, they are now even deleting Google's cache version of the explosive document originally deleted from the BLM website. And then we have the number one story on the internet Friday night, Saturday, and Sunday. Number one, you can go to our articles where it links to the big aggregate sites that track it. Google said it was number one story. The other sites, number one, Alexa, number one story. In the world was Harry Reid. And so now we learn who's who. We see the so-called conservative talk show host running around saying this isn't true, protecting Harry Reid. Because it's a big deal. You know, if the Chinese can't buy up Hollywood, and the communist, and if they can't buy up the oil fields, and if they can't buy up the... And by the way, if they wanted to come pay for your private property, that's fine. But no, they go and kick farmers and ranchers off land that they have the grazing rights to. And then they just, make a little investment here and hire a few people's kids that happen to be in the U.S. Senate. And then they get to have the property and get a nice cut of the energy deal, whether it ever even gets built. They use government energy funds to build it. Hell, just have an office building like some of these energy companies. Or they just have an office building, you know, and there's nobody in it. Like Solyndra, and you get $500 million. I guess Solyndra didn't happen, huh? Either? Another conspiracy theory I Remember Drudge? They said it was a conspiracy theory. There's a $5,000 fine this year. You don't get Obamacare if you own a business. Of course, that's in the bill, but doesn't matter. Matt Drudge is a conspiracy theorist, too.
Why does the United States spend the largest percentage of GDP in the world on healthcare? Why do we have the highest cancer rates on the planet? The highest rates of diabetes, autism, and every other major disease? It all comes down to one thing. We are what we eat. Our food is devoid of nutrition and processed with poisons and additives. Our water is filled with toxic poisons and big pharma runoff. All of this has been engineered by design. We can turn the tide against the eugenicist by giving ourselves the nutrients our body desperately needs. To learn more, visit InfoWarsHealth.com. The site is literally packed with audio and video featuring top health professionals who don't bow down to Big Pharma. The fight against the New World Order starts with you, and you can't stand against the machine of your sick, tired, and obese. When you visit InfoWarsHealth.com, be sure and check out the catalog with nearly 400 life-changing products and get free shipping when you sign up for AutoShip. This is Alex Jones for InfoWarsLife.com. The latest in preparedness is now here. An electrically stabilized colloidal silver solution that can be added to both your home cabinet and preparedness pack alike. Concentrated to 30 parts per million in what has been dubbed the Survival Silver Solution. The new InfoWars Life Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver is the answer for you and your family. And it's entirely free of toxic artificial additives that are loaded into many products. The InfoWars Life Silver Bullet Silver is so powerful that it is concentrated into a 2-ounce bottle and is not recommended for extended continual use. This is not a low-grade formula. We are working with one of the top laboratory manufacturers in the United States to bring you the best form of colloidal silver using electrical processes within a base of deionized water for your preparedness storage or your home kitchen. Purchase your bottle of InfoWarsLife.com Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver today and find other amazing supplements at InfoWarsLife.com.
A chemical spill contaminating the water supply in 9 West Virginia counties.
This year alone, over 300,000 people in West Virginia had their drinking water contaminated.
What are the health effects of having these drugs in our drinking water?
It's forced medical treatment without the consent of residents.
My friends, water filtration is one of the most basic actions you can take to protect you and your family from the harmful toxins and heavy metals in your tap water.
On average, the county says it sprays with glyphosate at least once a week.
Few filters cut out the glyphosates that is found in water supply. Worldwide. Remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, hydrofluorosilicic acid, sodium hexafluorosilicate.
Fluoride, it is in tea, it's in coffee, it's in water, it's in bread, it's in toothpaste.
It is our responsibility to protect our families. The establishment's not going to do it. It's time to take action. It's time to filter our water. Visit InfoWarsStore.com and use promo code WATER to get 10% off their entire family of incredible products. Or call toll free 888-253-3139.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
You know, I had a great private conversation with Ron Paul yesterday, a lengthy one, and he's just doing a lot of great, exciting things. It was a private conversation, but down the road, I'm sure folks will hear. Just so many interesting things going on. Liberty is certainly on the march on a planetary level. But there's going to be pushback against that. You know, today we pay our tax money, the private run-for-profit Federal Reserve's collection agency, the IRS, that wasn't set up till 1913. And then on average, Americans didn't pay income tax until World War II. They called it a war tax. And then in 51, they made it permanent. Just like we didn't have property taxes in this country the last 100 years, and it wasn't universal till about 30 years ago. You don't own your land, folks, if you pay a property tax. It's not really your land. You pay a rent. Clive Bundy and 7 generations of his family since the 1870s have the surface foraging water rights. And for those that don't know, this is universal across Europe, England, and the U.S. It's common law, certified by state and federal law. That if you were the first in a territory or area and you use the water and the range, you have the claim on the land. Now, they've used ignorance to distract the public and say, Bundy's not paying his taxes, he's lazy. If you're an illegal coming and having an anchor baby, or you're a corporation getting corporate welfare like Solyndra, that's fine. or if you're Microsoft, you know, paying zero tax or whatever, that's okay. But if you're Clive Bundy producing beef for this country, you're a low-down, lazy, freeloading piece of garbage. According to Neocon Radio and MSNBC and CNN and Media Matters that the White House runs. And then they went further. We, last week, got the BLM documents from the Google cache. They'd taken them off the BLM site where they said Clive Bundy is a recharge zone area set aside where we're going to use this area for the solar panels next door. We got to use him for the power lines, and we've got to use him as a set aside under international UNESCO rules where you can't use the property. That's how they do it. They have a, quote, carbon sink, as they call it. That's the global treaty. That if they're going to use this, well, your land can't be used. It's Nature Conservancy stuff. And we're showing the documents on screen right now. They've since pulled it off Google. They're so upset, and they've got Reed running around with people running defense for him saying this doesn't exist. They're in a lot of trouble, folks. Now, we've got him to the bottom of the hour, maybe longer. I want to go to him now to cover the waterfront and to discuss everything that's unfolding. But I wanted to play Harry Reid saying it's not over yet yesterday with the most disgusting you-know-what-eating grin. The true grin of a psychopath, kleptocrat, I mean, it just says a trillion words. The smugness of thinking he's untouchable, that he's invincible, all the horrible things, the gun grabbing, the open borders, the attacks on families. This guy, and I'm not in the LDS, so I don't want to speak for folks, but the Mormons I know are all upstanding, really hardworking, good people at the front lines of fighting the New World Order. I want to know why Harry Reid's at the forefront of destroying this country and the world. I want to ask why he hasn't been thrown out of his church. Maybe that's not my business, but let me throw that at you, Clive Bundy. What's your take on this man? I wouldn't call him a Christian. I wouldn't call him anything but a scallywag.
Well, I can tell you one thing. The people of the state of Nevada elected him. They elected him to the United States Senate to take care of business on the, like, things like fighting foreign wars and doing the business with the other countries. They didn't elect him to come back to Nevada and have anything to do with this public land of Clark County, Nevada. So this is not none of his business. He has no jurisdiction authority. We didn't elect him to be here. We haven't asked him to be here. Harry, get your back where you're supposed to be and do what you're supposed to be doing.
If you had Harry Reid in front of you right now, what would you say to him? Because he definitely watches and listens to this show.
I would tell him the exact same thing I just told you. I did tell Harry right now. That's where we never elected him to come down here and bring his army and against we the people. We never did do that, and we're not going to accept that one more time ever.
Well, you're definitely a ghost of our forefathers. That's exactly how they talked, and it's so alien now for a lot of city slickers to hear somebody saying, I won't back down. I want to play this clip of Harry Reid.
Is there anything you would like to say about what's going on down south with Clive Bundy and the BLM?
Well, it's not over. You know, we can't have an American people that violate the law and just walk away from it. So it's not over.
Unbelievable. You know, I think it's violating the law to taser people for no reason for free speech or to body slam women from behind or set dogs on people or to point guns at everybody saying, we will shoot if you cross the line. Sir, we have the audio. We've played the video. It's a viral video. You were there with David Knight, my reporter, and Josh Owens, the cameraman. Around 1,000 people. So historical. Looked like Ceausescu's Romania when the people turned on him, or the fall of the Berlin Wall, or if Tiananmen Square would have gone better. Describe what it was like when you decided to say, hey, we're going in to get the cattle, we're going over their line, and you know, just like Lexington saying, we're not going to fire the shot heard around the world, but if they fire, we'll fire all the rest. What was that like, Mr. Bundy?
Well, sort of realize or feel the setting, know the setting. We had the Clark County Sheriff Doug Gillespie standing right beside me, and he had made a statement and been negotiating with the enemy, the BLM, and come there to give we the people a statement, and the people didn't accept his statement. So the people give him a mandate to disarm those people over in that compound, the BLM. Those militants that were were armed over there and been tormenting us for several weeks.